Jennings won't go from outside the arc.
We're seeing one of the best three-point shooting teams in the league look anything like a good shooting team. They're certainly having an off day with their long-range game.
Jackson nicely executed. That's a 16-8 run for the Pistons.
Calderon
in possession.
Caron Butler.
There's the perfect pick. Hardaway against Butler. For two, puts it in. He's 4-for-5 from the field. Jennings walks it across. Moves around the defender. Has to adjust.
A good try.
Drummond has the double team close in. The Knicks with the ball in control. It's good. 20-point lead for the Knicks.
Oh, awesome. Thank you. I appreciate that.
The Pistons with the ball in possession. Jennings against Calderon. Ball comes loose. Reaches in for the steal. Stolen by Calderon. To the rim. And gets it to go.
That's nice body control right there on that layup. Good finish.
Blows past the defender. Jennings on the drive.
Yeah, fucking made that. Crazy.
Calderon against Jennings.
I don't know why you didn't give it to him, but all right.
Gets it off. That's a two-pointer.
Oh, that was it? I wasn't even paying attention to time. It's crazy. What time are you starting, Cheese? So I can decide when to wrap it all up here. And I'll host your channel.
Hey everyone, it's Jalen Rose. And it's time for the EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The Knicks put together a nice win here today. And what more could you say about their excellent field goal percentage? These guys couldn't miss even if they tried. The Knicks can point to these guys for their scoring output. The Pistons put up a fight, but didn't get their hands raised at the end. I'm sure they can't help but feel frustrated with the result, but they can't let that feeling linger. Sooner than later, they need to start thinking about the next matchup.
Game track. Steals.
The New York Knicks were very disruptive on defense, using great anticipation to get their hands on the ball. We saw plenty of steals in this matchup.
Andrew Garfield fought for a Spider-Man Marvel team-up. But I don't think he got his way, according to Cinema Blend on Twitter.
Player of the game.
Mark Ronson and Bruno Mars win Best Male Video for Uptown Funk.
His teammates with plenty of easy baskets. His assist total is
God, really? That video was awful.
Clever playmaking.
Ugh. That's why I don't watch those stupid award shows.
And here's a look at his stat line.
I've seen that video. That song is like a drill in the side of my head. I hate that fucking song.
Time now for the top plays of the game.
Number 3.
You better have fucking Melo. There was two like that, at least. Two or three like that. He should have had
these
two of them.
The latest scores when you take a look around.
All right. This has been a presentation. So I'll squeeze in one more then if I'm
until next time, I'm Jalen Rose.
Until you're ready.
On behalf of ESPN on EA Sports, I'm Jalen Rose, and we've got NBA action just moments away. The Toronto Raptors are looking to avenge this season against the New York Knicks.
They ain't gonna do shit.
Provided by none other than Mike Breen and Jeff Van Gundy.
Welcome to Madison Square Garden in New York as we get set for an Atlantic Division matchup between the New York Knicks.
Everything about the VMAs that comes across Twitter is probably the stupidest shit I've ever read. R.I.P. Wes Craven died? Wes Craven died. Screen Rant reports on Twitter that Wes Craven died. Holy shit.
Attacks the rim ferociously, game after game.
Hang on a sec. Son of a bitch. That's terrible. Damn, wasn't he working on another sequel? Wasn't he going to do another Freddy movie or something? Shit. That sucks. Did I download that other thing? Wow, so Wes Craven has passed away, everyone. Hang on a sec. It's crazy.
Tremendous rebounding point guard. And then defensively, that strong body, he gets into you, he makes it hard on
Sad.
You, and he sets a tone for this team. The Knicks coming off a gratifying win in their previous game against Detroit. Despite an opponent known for being amongst the best defensive teams in the NBA, they came away with a victory.
To summarize the last game, one word, shocked. Absolutely shocked that they were able to carve up such a great defensive team. Again, their offensive execution at times has been spotty, so to see it all come together against one of the top defensive teams in the league, outstanding performance, and it just shows you, this is their opportunity to improve, to grow, but they have to do it with consistency. It's got to turn into every night thing.
4-2.
possession. Care was ball handling, and there's a steal. Anthony up and in.
No degree of difficulty right there. Simple basketball, good result.
The assist from number three. The Raptors coming off a tough loss in their previous game against Golden State. They struggled with their perimeter defense. So many easy three-pointers.
One effort defense will not stand up over time. And that's what they gave in their last loss. They gave one effort defensively. So some good things, but then they stop. It's got to be multiple effort. It's got to be one thing to the next. And that is so important when you're guarding the three. And because they made just that one effort, they gave up open three-pointer after open three-pointer, and it cost them.
There's the double team. Jeff, you always talk about leadership in the organization. General Manager Masai Ujiri, Head Coach Dwayne Casey, they really have done a good job gaining some stability for this organization.
And it was so important. They were languishing for so long to build. Guys, their fan base, I just love what the Toronto Raptors are doing in the country up north.
It's good. A two-pointer. With the slam. The assist from number three, Jose Calderon.
The Raptors with the ball in control.
It's blocked. Puts up another shot. Can't knock it down.
Tremendous job making it difficult to get the ball to the basket. It's a first half lead. You have to set the tone defensively, and all they're doing is hoping the other team misses. Misses.
Anthony against Ross. Oh, excellent screen. It's blocked. 4 minutes gone.